Morning and Sairam to all the students. Welcome back in your English online class. So students, in our last session we had covered half of the chapter of our English book, and the chapter name was Traveling with the Grandfather Zoo. So this we had already covered. So as you know, this chapter is written by one of the famous author, Ruskin Bond. And as you all know about the Ruskin Bond, which I have already taught you in the previous session. So let's do a small recall about Ruskin Bond. So as you already know, who is Ruskin Bond? So Ruskin Bond is one of the famous Indian best known author. And he was born on 19th of May 1934, and he lives with his adopted family in Mussoorie. As he started his writing at the early age of 16, and his famous books are Our Trees Still Grow in Dera and The Blue Umbrella, The Night at Diwali, The Boys from the Hills. So this is all about the Ruskin Bond. So let's do a small recall what we had learned in our previous session. As we started our story about traveling with the grandfather zoo. So in this chapter, we had already covered that the author, the writer, was traveling with his grandfather, and they were traveling from Dera to Lucknow. As grandfather was having lot of pets like Timothy, tiger, and Chip, parrot, python, but grandmother did not like the python at all. So that's why they didn't take the python along with them. But what happened? Let's see this in the story. So let's start the reading. Take out your books and let's read the story. Grandmother had insisted that we leave the python behind, and grandfather had let it loose in the garden. Somehow it managed to snuggle itself into the tiffin basket. "Well, what are you staring at?" asked grandfather from his corner. So now when the writer wants to eat something, then they try to take out the basket under the berth, actually the food basket. Then they came to know about the python. "Well, what are you staring at?" asked grandfather from his corner. "It's the python," I said. "I is the writer, and it has finished all our dinner." Grandfather joined me, and together we looked down at what remained of the food. "Python don't chew, they swallow." Outlined along the length of the large snake's sleek body were the distinct shapes of a chicken, a pie, and a sick boiled egg. So what had happened? Python ate all the basket food. "We couldn't make out the ham sandwich, but presumably these had been eaten too, because there was no sign of them in the basket. Only a few apples remained. Evidently, the python did not care for apples." Grandfather snapped the basket shut and pushed it back beneath the berth. "We must not let grandmother see him," he said. "She might think we brought him along on purpose." "Well, I'm hungry." "Here, I," means the writer, "I," complained. Just then, Chips returned from one of his foray and presented me with a peanut. "Thanks," I said. "If you keep bringing me peanuts all night, I might last until morning." But it was not long before I felt sleepy. Grandfather had begun to nod, and the only one who was wide awake was the squirrel, still intent on investigating distant compartments. A little after midnight, there was a great clamor at the end of the corridor. Grandfather and I woke up. Timothy glowed in his sleep, and Popeye made complaining noises. Suddenly, there were cries of sap, sap, snake, snake. Grandfather was on his feet in a moment. He looked under the berth. The tiffin basket was empty. Now, student, hope you understand what happened. The tiffin basket was empty. It means Python has gone somewhere. The Python out, he said, the dash and the dash out of our compartment in his pajamas. I was close behind. About a dozen passengers were bunched together outside the washroom door. Anything wrong? Asked Grandfather casually. We can't get into the toilet, said someone. There's a huge snake inside. Now, what happened? The python was in the compartment toilet. The python was in the train's toilet. That's why there was a cross, and everyone was started talking about the python. Now, let's see what happened. What will be the solution of that python? Let me take a look, said Grandfather. I know all about snake. The passenger made way for him, and he entered the washroom to find the python curled up in the wash basin. After its heavy meal, he had become thirsty, and finding the lid of the tiffin basket easy to pry up, had set out in search of water. So that now you know the reason why the python was moving here and there, because after the heavy meal he was feeling thirsty. In search of the water, he just went to the washroom. Grandfather gathered up the sleepy overfed python and stepped out of the washroom. The passenger hastily made way for them. Nothing to worry about, said Grandfather cheerfully. It's just a harmless young python. He's had his dinner already, so no one is in any danger. And he marched back to our compartment with the python in his arms. As soon as I was inside, he bottled the python. Grandmother was sitting up on her berth. I knew you had do something foolish behind my back, she scrawled. You told me you had got rid of that creature, and all the time you have been hiding it for me. Now here, grandmother is grumbling. She was complaining because she doesn't like that creature. Here, creature means the python. Grandfather tried to explain that we had nothing to do with it, that the python had smuggled itself into the tiffin basket. But grandmother was unconvinced. What will Mabel do when she sees it? She cried despairingly. My aunt Mabel was school teacher in Lucknow. She was going to share our new house, and she was terrified of all reptiles, particularly snake. That's why now you know the reason why the grandmother was grumbling so much about this creature, because the aunt Mabel doesn't like the reptiles at all. We won't let her see it, said Grandfather. Back it goes into the tiffin basket. Early next morning, the train steamed into Lucknow. Aunt Mabel was on the platform to receive us. Grandfather let all the other passengers get off before he emerged from the compartment with Timothy on a chain. I had chip in my pocket, suitcase in both hands, Popeye stayed perched on grandmother's shoulder, eyeing the busy platform with considerable distrust. Aunt Mabel, a lover of good food, immediately spotted the tiffin basket, picked it up and said, "It's not very heavy. I'll carry it out to the taxi. I hope you have kept something for me." And what Aunt Mabel thought, that in the tiffin basket some sweet things are there. But actually, who was in the basket? Yes, Python was in the basket. "And whole chicken," I said. "We hardly ate anything," said Grandfather. "It's all yours, Auntie," I added. "Oh, good," exclaimed Aunt Mabel. "It's been ages since I tasted something cooked by your grandmother." And after that, there was no getting the basket away from her. Glancing at it, I thought I saw the lid buckling, but Grandfather had tied it down quite firmly this time, and there was a little likelihood of it suddenly busting open. An enormous 1950 Chevrolet taxi was waiting outside the station, and the family tumbled into. Timothy got onto the back seat, leaving enough room for Grandfather and me. Aunt Mabel sat in front with Grandmother and tiffin basket on her lap. So now they are ready to go to the Aunt Mabel house in a taxi. "Tell the taxi driver where to take us, dears," said Grandmother. "He is looking rather nervous." Aunt Mabel gave instruction to the driver, and the taxi shot off in the cloud of dust. Why the taxi driver was nervous? Because they are having a pet like a tiger, and Python was not appeared in front of them, but the taxi driver was very much nervous because he saw that they are having a young tiger with them. "Well, here we go," said Grandfather. "I'm looking forward to settling into the new house." Popeye, perched proudly on the grandmother's shoulder, kept one suspicious eye on the quivering tiffin basket. "All aboard," he quacked, "all aboard." "When we go to our new house, we found a light breakfast waiting for us on the dining table. "Isn't much," said Aunt Mabel, "but well, supplement it with the content of your hamper." And placing the basket on the table, she removed the lid. The python was half asleep. Yes, student, who was in the basket? The python was waiting in the basket with an apple in his mouth. Aunt Mabel was on eve to be tempted. She fainted away. Grandfather promptly picked up the python, took it into the garden and wrapped it over a branch of a guava tree. When Aunt Mabel recovered, she insisted that there was a huge snake in the tiffin basket. We showed her the empty basket. "You are seeing things," said Grandfather. What they said to the Aunt Mabel? "That you are seeing things. It must be the heat. All are making fool to the Aunt Mabel." What they said? "You seeing thing. It must be because of the heat." Grandmother said nothing, but Popeye broke into shriek of the maniacal laughter. Soon everyone, including a slightly hysterical Aunt Mabel, was doubled up with laughter. So here, this is a story about the traveling with the grandfather's zoo. Along with this story, I'm giving you a summary also. So here we have summary. Everyone has to read this chapter at home. underline the difficult words, find out the meaning from the dictionary and write in your rough notebook. Along with this, I am going to tell you that soon I will tell you about your internal assessment assignments which you have to submit according to the dates. So start learning, start preparing yourself for the elocution and letter writing. In the next video, I will tell you what is the topic for the elocution and letter writing for your internal assessment. Sairam.